Let's continue to explore distances from zero more closely. The jumping flea. So a bug is jumping around on a number line. If it starts at 1 and it jumps 4 units to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, it would land on 5. 5 is 5 units from 0. If the bug starts at 1 and jumps 4 units to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, it would land on negative 3. Negative 3 is 3 units away from 0. If the bug starts at 0 and jumps 3 units away, where might it land? Well, counting 3 spaces to the right would get us to 3, and counting 3 spaces to the left would get us to negative 3. What if the bug jumps 7 units and lands at 0? Where could it have started? Well, it depends. Counting 7 spaces to the right would get us to positive 7, and counting 7 spaces to the left of 0 would get us to negative 7. The absolute value of a number is the distance it is from 0. The bug is currently to the left of 0, so it's to the left, and the absolute value of its location is 4. Where on the number line is it? We know that 4 units to the left of 0 would make it negative 4. What if the bug is to the left of 0 and the absolute value of its location is 5? Where on the number line is it? Well, 5 units to the left of 0 is negative 5. What if the bug is to the right of 0 and its absolute value of the location where it's at is 2.5? Where on the number line could it be? If you said 2.5, that would be correct. Absolute value represents the distance of the number from 0 without worrying about the sign or direction. In a board game, 3 moves forward and 3 moves backward, both involve 3 jumps, even if you land in different spaces or places. Let's say that you start at 7, and you jump 3 units to backward, 1, 2, 3. That would put you at 4. If you start at 7 and you jump 3 spaces forward, 1, 2, 3, that would put you at 10. Both involve 3 jumps, even if you land in different places. Traveling 5 miles east or 5 miles west would put the same number of miles on your car's odometer, but you end up in different places depending on the direction. Earning $10 and spending $10 both involve the amount of $10, but in one case you gain it, and in the other, you lose it. Let's contrast the absolute value of negative 6 and 6. We can come to the conclusion that they have the same value, but represent the distance between 2 distinct points and 0. What is the difference between a number's opposite and a number's absolute value? Well, the opposite is another number on the number line. So negative 6 is the opposite of positive 6, whose distance from 0 is the same. Absolute value is a number that describes that distance. The absolute value of negative 6 and the absolute value of 6 is 6. Notice that we're not including our signs. The absolute value of a number is its distance from 0 on the number line. The absolute value of negative 7 is 7 because it is 7 units from 0. The absolute value of 5 is 5. Because it is 5 units away from 0. Let's continue to work with absolute value.